Hey guys, how's it going? I thought I'd give another gear video. This time I'm going to actually show you everything in my studio. The cave. For those of you that have noticed in my recent covers, I have a new 7-string guitar. I traded my Jackson Adrian Smith guitar and my original Ibanez S-Series 7-string. I ended up getting a Carvin 7-string. It was a custom guitar. The guitar originally belonged to my former guitar teacher, Oscar Ortega. He was selling it, and he was asking for either money or a fair trade or equal trade. I ended up trading those two guitars, and without further ado, I'm going to show you that guitar. So I'm going to ache over here like an old man and walk. So here she be. This is the Carvin. I think it's called the 707 or whatever. I can see the reflection of the camera. How do you like that? So it's a 7-string. It's from Carvin. We have gold hardware, golden logo, stainless steel frets. I think this is a ebony fingerboard with the stainless steel frets, like I mentioned. And there's no fret dots except on the neck right here. It took a little longer to get used to as I anticipated. But this thing's really fun to play. I love it. We have a neck through construction. I think this is Babinga. It looks like Babinga because when I was at MI, and if you are Facebook friends with me, I got to hold Tosin Abasi's 8-string guitar, and that was really cool. And I'm pretty sure this is a Babinga, two Babinga strips right here, and that's what it looked like to me. So I'm gonna show you the body again. We have a gold Floyd Rose tremolo style bridge. Yep, it's a licensed Floyd Rose, so that's good. In the case, there's a gold potentiometers. My teacher put in the black ones. Makes no difference. It's really, they're both cool looking. We have a, I think it's a 5-way pickup selector. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, 5-way. So I'm gonna move the tremolo arm. We have a humbucking system, a single coil, and another humbucker. So this one full on down, we get the humbucker, split coil, single coil, split, and humbucker. So this guitar is fantastic. It's like I said, it's neck through. It's really heavy. You know, heavy. Heavy metal! So if you notice right here on the truss rod cover, it's kind of hard to see. It says Chato. Originally, Oscar is from Guatemala, and when he got this guitar, I think it was when he was making his first album, Fruits of the Morning. I'll put that in my description so you guys can check it out. Really, check him out. He's really cool. Going back to this, I believe he told me Chato is what his grandmother would say, and that album was dedicated to her, because she passed away when that album came out, I believe, or before it came out. And in Spanish, Chato means, like, little boy. So she would say, like, come here, little boy. You know, like, Chato, vámonos. I'm not good with Spanish, so don't get mad, please. So this is very significant to Oscar, and out of respect, I'm going to keep this on here. I'm going to keep everything on here, so Oscar, don't worry. Your baby is taken care of by your former student. So, that's that. This guitar is fantastic. I think this would be, like, my main guitar if I'm ever going to be on tour. And so, without further ado, I'm going to put the sucker back. This is the Carvin. That's that. I'm going to put the sucker back now. And now I'm going to show you the rest of my gear. Let me unplug the camera. Alright. So, I'm going to give you a little tour, inside joke if you're a member of my family. So, all my guitars, except for the 7-string and the Jackson Adrian Smith, those guitars are gone, because I got this Carvin. I have everything in string order on this rack right here. I have my 8-string, my Carvin, my Gibson, my George Lynch guitar, and my Jackson. And one guitar I actually never mentioned was this one. This is a 94, I think it's a 94, it's a Guild S100 Polera. Now the Guild Polera has been around since the 1960s. This particular one I believe came out in 94. It was originally my dad's, and he gave it to me recently. Everything on here is original. If you look on YouTube and type in School of Rock Eagle, Idaho, you'll see me with this guitar playing Kashmir by Led Zeppelin. It was during our Led Zeppelin season. 2 years ago, I think. So this is kind of like the Dan Electro guitar that Jimmy Page had. Well, if you know what I mean. It's not exactly a Dan Electro, but I kind of treated it as such. And now we're going to move on. Well, there's the acoustics. My Ovation 12-string, my Ovation 6-string. And you might ask, what in the hell is this little thing right here? Monster. Let me move my strap. This is a Barrington baritone saxophone. If you guys can recall, I used this saxophone for Everything Went Numb by Streetlight Manifesto. This is my main saxophone that I when I was in the school band, this was my main saxophone. I started out playing a tenor sax, which I'll show in a few minutes, but later on, a couple years later, I ended up switching to baritone sax, and I loved it. If you're going to be a sax player, I highly suggest playing a baritone sax, but, you know, play an alto or a tenor first to get used to it if you're a new player, and then you move on to a baritone. That's what I suggest. So, that's the baritone sax. It's keyed in E-flat, just like the alto. And I use this little harness for all my saxophones, you know, just for easier use. Just makes it easy. And I'm gonna ache over here, step over here now. I'm gonna go in the down one size. This is the, I have a Barrington tenor sax. This one I got around my 8th grade year. I don't think there's any footage of me playing this one, unless my sister has a YouTube channel, and I can give you that video of me playing the tenor. So that's a tenor sax. Here is the alto. My other sister, oldest sister to be exact, she played this alto. She gave it to me for my 16th birthday. And I have many good ideas for this saxophone right here. And then the next size down is kind of hard to see. It's the soprano saxophone. I also got this in 8th grade. It's same key as the tenor. They're both in B-flat. This one is commonly used by Kenny G, who was one of my saxophone inspirations. And the reason why I played the tenor, because I liked Clarence Clemens from Bruce Springsteen. He played a tenor. And, oh, this video. What was I thinking? I used this saxophone for 2 videos. They were just for fun, you know. I want to do a sax video again. And I used this for the Duane Eddy song Rebel Rouser. And I used this one for the Elton John Billy Joel song. What is it? Still Rock and Roll to Me. My memory is just going crazy. When you go to an IB school and you do a lot of things, and you want to make sure your grade stays up, you end up losing a lot of memory. So, if you want to go to an IB school, just make sure you write stuff down, and so you can recall stuff and not make mistakes like I do. I should have written something down instead of trying to use my brain for memory. Well, anyway, there is footage of me playing this one at School of Rock, but I have no idea where it is. So, I used this saxophone for Can't You Hear Me Knockin' by the Rolling Stones. And that's that. And the next thing I have here is my Casio keyboard. My first video ever on YouTube, I used this for my metal song, No Escape from Seduction. That was from a long time ago. That was 2 years ago when I recorded that sucker. And for the sake of my 4 minutes left I have on this camera, here's my amp that I use. It's a Line 6, 75 watts. And for the keyboard, I use my dad's amplifier. It's a Fender amp, Fender Deluxe. I just have that connected to the keyboard. Makes a better sound because I don't use the speakers on this keyboard. So, that's what I use for loudness, and I always cover the windows whenever I make a video. So, really, where I am is the bonus room. Oh, if you're wondering why I have a blanket, pillows all over here. Whenever I play my Xbox, there's a glare from the window to the TV. There's the Xbox right there. So, it's just really annoying. And I have a new speaker system. I'm using these new speakers now. It has a subwoofer on there. There's a subwoofer right there. That's what I use. There's some of my cases. An extension cord for, this has a shorter wire, so I gotta use that. I'm pretty sure this is called an extension cord or a power strip, whatever you want to call it. And, well, since you guys were wondering, what do I use to put my camera on here? I use a stool and a cardboard box. This is my hillbilly music stand. Well, tripod. I just pop the camera exactly in the middle, and then I get the perfect, almost perfect, balance. I got about 2 minutes left on here. So, that's that. That's the updated gear review. I'm going to do another review soon. I don't know yet. So, like, subscribe. If you have any friends with YouTube channels, tell them to subscribe to me. I'd appreciate that. And I'll see you guys next video.